Anupama, you can bring Rekha right now. Let's give her a topic and let's speak to her and see what how she does.
Sure, Vishal, give me a moment. Rekha, you can unmute and come on video. We'll give you 30 seconds to prepare your background.
Yeah, as Rekha comes on video in about right now, can you just spotlight her video too? Yeah, there you go. Rekha, good to see you. Where are you from?
I'm from Bangalore.
You're from Bangalore?
I'm from Bangalore. Yeah.
Very nice.
But at present, I'm in Kuwait. My husband works here as a chemical engineer. He's into a petrol chemical engineer. So now, because due to the lockdown and all that 2 years, my school was just going on online, sections were going on. And that is managed by my staff. So that is the reason I'm here for some time. But then I thought I realized that time.
Said Kuwait?
Pardon?
Do you know why I smiled when you said Kuwait?
No, I don't.
So this individual, I was just going to show his video later on. I don't know if you have watched his video.
I watched his video. Rahul has shared his video for me. Before I start this section with you, Rahul had shared this video with
me. Oh, nice. So for everybody, so for example, she mentioned Kuwait. You said your husband works there, you said, right?
Yeah, my husband works for a petrochemical company.
So after this, after talking to Rekha, I'm going to...
Hi, my name is Subish Menon. I joined this SIB program. So before the program...
So he's from Kuwait. So anyways, that's the reason I was smiling. So Rekha, you'll have 30 seconds to think and 2 minutes to speak on a topic. Do you have a pen and paper if you want to write down the topic quickly? Okay.
Yeah, 1 second.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Okay. So after telling the topic, I'll give you 30 seconds because it's a very simple topic. I'm not going to ask you to speak on nuclear bomb and you know, our prime minister's plan to deal with terrorism. We're not talking about the very simple topic. How many years of work experience do you have overall, Rekha?
5 to 6 years.
Okay. Your topic is, you said you owned a school, you said?
Yeah, I'm a director of a Bachpan school in Sanjay Nagar. Only one branch I have at present. And I also, I'm a owner of a Lakme salon in Bangalore.
Nice. So your topic, I'm making it very specific to you because you said you own a school, is the number one secret of being a great teacher. The number one secret of being a great teacher. I'll give you 30 seconds for you to prepare and then you'll have 2 minutes to speak, okay, on this topic. Let's see how you deal with it and then we'll talk about how to make it better. You have 20 seconds to think. The number one secret of being a great teacher. Number one secret of being a great teacher. There you go. All right, 10 seconds, get ready, wake up. And you'll have, so I have a small timer here. Kaushik, do you have that timer thing ready? It's better. Leave that, Kaushik. No problem. We'll do it here. Okay. So your time starts in 5 seconds. Are you ready, Rekha?
Yeah.
And after that, are you open to some feedback on what went well and what went wrong?
Sure.
Okay. Yes. Your time is only 2 minutes. The number one secret of being a great teacher. 3, 2, 1, start.
Hello. To number one secret to be a great teacher is like, I am from the background of a play school where I am connected with the children who are LKG, UKG, pre-KG and all that. They are the children who really need, you know, you have to be like them itself. Like, you know, you have to make them understand. If suppose I say this is an apple, I have to make them understand very in a very clear and very in a very, you know, children's in their own age, I have need to explain to them about that apple, whatever it is, or even a small thing if I take also very in a very precise and a very simple way. I need to explain. I don't need to explain to them with a very good English or with very big English and all that. I feel that. 11 seconds, 1 minute is left. I don't know. I'm still not getting any words.
Keep going. You can do it.
And in a funny way, in a very precise way, I need to explain to them that how to explain to be a good teacher. I think I failed somewhere.
Keep on. Don't give up. Use the time that you have.
Being a secret of being a good teacher is to get connected with the kid and explaining him to more easily and more precise way how to explain, how to be, whatever I speak, it should, he should be understand the concept. It's very bad, man.
I don't disagree.
It's too bad. I'm not getting words actually, because suddenly you give me, I know things, but I'm not able to put in words. That's it.
Okay.
But good job, Rekha. You tried. You started. Yes. You continued. When we asked you to keep doing it, you actually tried doing it. So good job. May I ask you, do you have a son?
Yeah, I have two kids. Two sons.
Okay. You have two sons. Okay. You could have spoken about them as well. Vishal is moving on to you. What do you want to...
So Rekha, what happened in speak in 10-15 seconds? What happened? Why did you not use the entire 2 minutes? Let's talk about it.
Actually, I'll just explain to you about that. Like, you know, I run the school. It's successfully I'm running. I have around 150 students. But when it comes to talking to teachers or when it comes to talking to parents, I have little this kind of little fear in me, and that confidence I'm not able to give that. Might be if I come overrun that and come out, I think I can also bring up in one more school like that. I can build up this ideas of what I implement for my school or what I do for my business. I have good, but then it when it comes to speaking or when it comes to what to tell, conveying it, or when it comes that there where I lose, I feel I need to be dependent on somebody else. I need to catch some. Staff will do,
I understand
my work
that. I understood the problem like in 15 seconds. I understand that. I thank you for also telling me that. What I'm asking is what made you not speak for 2 minutes? What was going inside your head for the 2 minutes?
I was not getting words. I was not getting sentences.
Okay. Yeah. So if your son comes, or if like a parent comes to you and says, you know, what, how can somebody be a great teacher? You could probably speak for 10-15 minutes on how to be a great teacher, can't you?
Oh, yeah, I can speak. It's not that I can't speak, but then again, I'll just tell about my school and I'll make them convince about my school. That's it.
So what you lack, I can go on a whole different tangent for about next 20 minutes about what was missing in your speech. I'll quickly tell you, first of all, I applaud that you raised hand and said, Vishal, coach me and pick me. I appreciate that. That tells me you're an open-minded and you're coachable. Is that true?
Yeah, true. Thanks.
So now let me tell you what was missing. There are many points. I don't want to overwhelm you with too many things right now. The main thing that you lacked, okay, two things, Rekha, and it can be overcome. Don't worry about this. Okay. If you're coming to the Extraordinary Speaker Transformation, you will laugh at this problem 3 months from now. Do you want that?
Yeah, sure. I want it. That is first the reason actually my age is around 48, so after so many years I've come as I need to build up it. That is
your problem can be solved in the next 48 days.
Thanks.
Okay. So the first problem in your speaking was that you started thinking about how do I prove my point, and that created a pressure in you even 5 seconds before you started, that I'm going to speak now. Hi, this is the thing. I run the school and LKG and UKG and Apple and I teach, right? So too many information too soon. You started off well, and it is like a good start. You know what happened is that, you know, sometimes you have a Coke and if you just shake the bottle and you open it, what happens? And then? So for first 15 seconds, you were like very, very enthusiastic, and then it went down. The reason is because you did not know the end point where you are going with your speech. Does that make sense to you, Rekha?
Yes. Yes, I got
it. So the first main problem was that unclear and uncertainty about what you're going to convey, number one. And second is you did not have the proper outline, a structure and a template on how to convey your point. You are going sentence by sentence. You are not going, you know, point by point in your mind. And that's the reason you're like, I'm done. Oh, 11 seconds left. Oh, shit. No, 1 minute, 11 seconds left, right? So now I'm going to coach you. Are you open to some coaching for the next 2 minutes? How to speak in a powerful manner? Okay. So forget anybody's watching right now. You tell me one thing. And do not tell me a lot of people. Just give me the answers to my questions. That will help us save time and come to a good speech. Tell me about a name of a student. One of your favorite students. Name of one of your favorite students.
Favorite student is... This is his name.
Take your time. Take 15 seconds to think about one of your favorite
Slok,
students.
Slok.
Okay. How old is Slok?
Slok is just done UKG. You know, he must be five years.
5 years. Okay. He's a part of your school. He's a student.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay. When you said you're 48, Rekha. When you did your schooling, tell me a name of one of your favorite teachers that you had.
Basanta ma'am.
At what age did you find her as a teacher? How old were you at that time?
I was around 14 years when she was my teacher. I really liked as her a teacher when I was in 14 years, like eight.
Okay, and what did she teach, Basanta ma'am?
She was a science teacher.
Science. Okay. Why did you like her a lot? One quality that you liked her a lot as a teacher?
Because when I was a child, when I was learning science and all the mathematics and science teacher, she was some concept I was not understanding at all, though they were teaching me and all. But when she started teaching for us from sixth or seventh, but when she started teaching us, the concept was so clear that that subject became my favorite. Oh, that is the reason I started one of my favorite shows.
So she simplified complicated subjects.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay. Apart from her teaching, is there anything else in her personal character that you liked in her?
No, not anything that I don't remember.
Was she kind? Was she generous?
Very kind. And whenever you have any issues or any problems, you get connected to her, you go and tell, I need to understand. She'll say, come to my staff room this time, I'll teach you. That and all was there.
Did that happen to you? You ever went to her and she took you to the staff room?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's come to Slok. Slok is 5 years old. Why is he one of your favorite students?
He was there in my school from the pre-nursery, he was there. And he was such a boy that you get attracted to him. When he was small also, he could just, come and talk. If I'm sitting in my room also, he sees me, he runs and come and he speaks to me. And then he went for first standard, second. And he was like very kind of a family child for us. Very get connected child. Suppose I sometimes come to Kuwait, when I have some vacation, I just come here and my staff manages this group. So when I go back, he's the only person, he tells me that, ma'am, you are absent for so many days. He misses me. Though I'm not I don't go and teach him all the time. One or two sections only I take for my kids when I just talk to them commonly with the whole group. So, but I see him that he observes that I'm there or not there or what it is. So if I'm not there for 1 month or if I'm not there and then I go back and then I start going to school, then he's the only person who'll Rekha, ma'am, you're absent. He'll ask me. So that is how I get connected with him.
Very nice. Very happy to know about this. So now that, are you ready to see what a great speech looks like for the content is yours.
Sure.
But now I become Rekha. Mm-hmm. Okay, your name is Vishal. Your name is Vishal Sarkar. My name is Rekha. You say, Rekha, speak on the number one subject of number one secret of being a great teacher. Give me the topic now.
Rekha, speak on the number one topic of to become a great speaker.
Thank you, Vishal. I remember when I was 14 years old, I fell in love with a teacher named Basanta ma'am. She used to teach science, and the reason I liked her a lot is not because she looked very nice, not because she was most enthusiastic, but because I remember anytime we had a complicated topic or a complicated chapter or a complicated subject, I went to her and she completely simplified it for me. it felt like I was not studying science. It felt like it was a game. It was a play for me after that. And I remember there was one time I was so nervous to go to her because, you know, I was not understanding some simple concept about science. And I went to her and she said, Rekha, come on in. And she invited me inside the staff room. She made me sit in one of the teacher's chairs. And on the table, I sat with my short legs and my short hand as a child. And she taught me that subjects. And I still remember that in 2021. When I think about today, I try to be the same kind of teacher for Shlok. Who is Shlok? Shlok is just 5-year-old. And Shlok comes and speaks. And he's like a family child and a family student for us in my school. And the thing is, anytime I miss, because I'm being kind to him and I'm simplifying complicated subjects for him, anytime I don't come to the school as the owner sometimes, she says, Rekha ma'am, why did you not come to the school for so many days? I'm glad that Vasantha ma'am's legacy is living within me. The question is not about Vasantha ma'am. The question is not about me. The question is about you. Who can you be a great teacher to? Maybe it's your child. Maybe it's your wife. Maybe it's your husband. Maybe it's your team member. What kind of complicated subject can you simplify? How can you be kind to them? How can you invite them to the staff room, to the Zoom room, to your conference room to simplify subjects? Because remember, a good teacher can simplify great complicated topics into simple manners.
Wow.
Now, Rekha, I spoke, but that was your speech. It was your content, right?
True.
All I did is took everything and I molded it into a 2-minute speech. Do you like what we did here together?
Yeah, very good. Yeah, true.
Very nice.
I liked it.
So Rekha, in the next 3 months and a couple of months, how many of you liked it? Just type me in the chat box as well. Let's hear and let's give a round of applause to Rekha. Rekha, glad you played and it's going to be great.
Thank
I'm going to give
you
the next part of the tips. Thank you. Appreciate
thank
that.
You,
thank
you. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Awesome. 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 Guys, this is how you do it. Okay. Now, if you never learn the right techniques, you can never do it on your, like you cannot just do it just because you're practicing a lot. Never happens that way. Do you understand what I'm talking about, guys? Yes. So all you have to do, I appreciate that comment. All you have to do is take, Anupama, would you take Rekha to the participant
sure.
list now?
Thank you for joining us, Rekha, and moving you back.
You're
and you
thanks, sir. Thanks.
Thanks.
Hi, my name is Subish Menon. So I joined this SIB program. So before the program, I was not able to speak fluently, I mean with the flow. My speech was not structured. But after the program, I came to know about different frameworks and now I'm able to structure my speech. The second improvement which I made was I could easily relate to different vocal tones. Before I was not able to used to speak in a single tone, but after this I've been using multiple vocal tones which I learned from the SIB and which has added a complete dimension to my speech. And the third improvement I would say is I learned a lot of vocabulary, like different idioms and different words that can really add some that spice into your speech that I had before. I know that I just used to use my own vocabulary. So these are three improvements which I made. So thank you, Vishal. Thank you, the entire team, for having this wonderful SIB. So the best part of the program is actually the accountability. I mean, even if you miss, there were a lot of assignments, but even if you miss those assignments, there were people to really follow up and really encourage us and motivate us. The group synergy was amazing. So that's the best part of the program, which I feel is. And the value I got from this program is 100 times, 100x. And even if I could pay 100 times more, I would be satisfied. So I also want to say that Anand, according to me, has made the most improvement in this program. And Vishal Sarkar as a mentor, I mean, he is, I don't think there are any words to describe him. For me, he has been everything for the last 4 months. I mean, my schedule has been around him. It's the instructions he used to give, the messages he used to give. Everything has really influenced me a lot. It has connected with me deeply. And I have decided that he is the mentor for my life. So my final message to all of you is just go for it. There is nothing. I have attended a lot of programs before, like probably 52 programs. But this has been the program which I have been waiting for my life. And so I'm sure that you will not look back. Amazing. There's a lot of fun, there's a lot of learning. Everything is done in a very professional manner. So please, my only request to you is don't think too much. Just jump into it and find your success.